All right, welcome back to Nico Knows Tech. I'm Nico, and as promised, I'm going to teach you how to protect your PC all in one step, but without firearms. Stay tuned.
The step that we're going to do is called tronscript. When you're infected, you don't need to go through all these steps, you know, downloading malware bytes, all these things. When you're really infected, scanner might not save you, because you're still going to need to rebuild Windows. There could be system corruption, and who knows if that scanner is going to catch it all. So right off the bat, I'm going to direct you to tronscript. And if you just Google search, or you'll see it right here on Reddit, Tron fights for the user. And this is a very powerful script. It will remove telemetry, which is Microsoft SpyNet. It's great for privacy. It's going to debloat Windows a lot, like the debloater will. And you just go down to this website here, and you scroll down, and you'll see the links right here. I'm going to use the official one right there. You can use the torrent or the EXE, but just there's the latest version right there. So go ahead and download that. I already have it downloaded, so what we're going to do is we're just going to copy this over to the desktop. All right. And on an infected machine, or even on regular machines, where did it go? It's not on the desktop. Okay, well, there it is. Got lucky this time. We'll see what happens. You'll right-click on the Tron, and whatever version it is, and you'll run it as administrator. You're going to get this warning. It's going to say don't run. Click more info, then run anyway. Windows Defender, if you're infected, your antivirus is lying to you anyway. Windows is lying to you anyway. What this is doing, it's extracting the files of the script that it needs in order to run. And now on your desktop, see here, there should have been two folders that popped up, but they didn't. They're there. You could look around and don't panic. This is very common in Windows, especially on an infected machine. So look, it's not there. So you could look in program files trying to find it, but really, it's on the desktop. And all you see, look, something downloads, not there. You're like, where'd it go? And so just right click on the desktop background and hit refresh, and poof, there it is. Now in the Tron folder, you'll open that, and the two files, tron.bat and resources folder, those have to be on the desktop. So you can just click and drag both of those over to the desktop. And then you're going to run tron.bat as administrator. And then you'll see this window coming up. It's going to be detecting that you have SSDs. This is not defrag SSDs, which is not good. Here, it's going to ask you, it's going to tell you if you accept the license. You have to type in all caps, I agree, I space agree. And then hit enter. And then you have to hit enter again. Press any key to continue. It's showing that it's going to skip defrag, see, because it's detected I have an SSD, and defragging is very bad for solid-state drives. If a hard disk drive, that might be a good idea. But it's going to automatically do this. There's no decisions. This is just one step. All of this is automated. Right now, it's creating a restore point just in case you don't like how your system was before. Or maybe you're running this after a new install, which you know, I sometimes do. Or even if I just see some kind of funny flicker. Now there might be an infection and I might as well, you know, do a full maintenance of Windows. First thing this did was run rkill. Now if I was going to manually do this, the first thing I would do is get rkill, which kills malware tasks that are running in the background. Instead of you having to go through task manager and having to kill them and end process and hoping you got them, but they keep popping back up, rkill kills them. Then we can actually run system scans and virus scans, malware scans, without malware lying to Windows and saying, you know, and basically they're blind. So when you're really infected, your virus scanner can't see anything. And process killer is another one. And and it's backing up the registry, which you'll see in /logs/tron. You can see what everything that happened. And if you don't like the registry changes, well, you just double click on that reg file and it'll put it back to where it was. And let's see. It sets your restore point max to 7%, which is recommended. And it's doing a whole bunch of privacy things. It's running CCleaner, temp file cleaner, cleaning Internet Explorer, your SSL certificates. All this stuff is might have been websites that you saved your form history with. It might have been a bank that you no longer bank with. I mean, you're gonna get a new one next time you go into the bank. You're not even gonna notice when you go to your, you know, Chase.com. You're gonna get a new certificate, so clearing that doesn't hurt anything, and it does help to clear them every once in a while. Now it's doing the clearing the Windows Update cache. That could be 10, 20 gigabytes of just stored Windows Update installed files and programs that they didn't delete after the update. They just sit there, and then it just gets bigger and bigger and bigger. Instead of, you know, they would be better if they use the temp file, because then you could just clear the temp file and they'll be there. But okay, it's also right now it's removing all the junkware, kind of like the debloater does, not on the same scale, but it does debloat, you know, the obvious blacklisted stuff. So, and it's doing a disk cleanup, so it's going to clear all those temp files and app data for things that are no longer used. It might have been applications that you used years ago and uninstalled, but there might be gigs of app data that's still stored in Windows, and that doesn't help your OS at all. And then now we're finally looks like we're going into, oh yeah, it's doing the hard uninstall of the Microsoft junk. OneConnect, the Skype that you can't remove. You can always download Skype and then uninstall it later, but the one that comes with Windows, that one you can't remove, and that's a part of SpyNet. It'll remove OneDrive. OneDrive is owned by Microsoft, and then you'll have two copies of your documents and pictures and videos. One's automatically on the cloud, whether you want it to be or not. Then you might delete a file, and then why is it still on OneDrive? Or you might, it's even hard to keep track of, am I looking at my computer hard drive, or am I looking at the cloud? And everyone uses Dropbox anyway, so getting rid of that is great. It's doing did a major debloat, so that's gonna speed things up. Let's see, now it's doing virus scans. Russ Sofos, Kaspersky, it did run I think it's TASS, and that kills rootkits. And rootkits are nasty things. They're in your boot sector, so you could scan your whole hard drive, and you might have nothing in your files, but in your boot sector, it's gonna come back. You could have cleaned all your viruses, but the moment you rebooted, virus is back. Rootkits are terrible. And it even uses McAfee Stinger, one of the few things McAfee got right. And then here, after the disinfect is done, it's running DISM tool. This is comparing your Windows 10 image, or Windows 7, Windows 8, even Vista, with what Microsoft has. And if it's been modified by malware or it's corrupted, it's gonna automatically repair it with the one Microsoft has. So you're gonna have essentially a clean install without having to lose all your stuff. After this, it's going to run the SFC command, which I covered briefly in my last video, which is a system file scanner. It's going to check all your system files, everything in System 32. If anything are corrupted, any missing files, missing DLLs, missing any of those, it'll automatically repair them. And all this is done for free. It's doing a check disk, checking for, you know what a check disk is. You know, we've been doing that since Windows 95, Windows 10, Windows 1.0, 3.0. But yeah, no bad sectors, we're golden. And this also deleted telemetry. It disabled telemetry right here. Telemetry is Microsoft SpyNet. Everything you do, every keystroke, it's not even really disclosed, but we do know that they do watch everything that we do with our apps. They check what our hardware is, where our software is, where we go, what we do. And you're opted into this by default. but you can turn this off. And it's a bit difficult without some tools and certain things. For example, it disabled NVIDIA telemetry where it was in the GPU. Here, everything's done. Here is telling you everything's done. It also tells you where the logs are. It ran malware bytes as well, installed that, and it uninstalled it for you, so you don't have to do that anymore like older versions. And at this point, you could just hit enter and it'll close the window. And now you can just restart your machine and everything will be golden. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you next time.